For this tutorial, we will be building a pipeline to find individual worms in subregions, and then extract measurements. To begin, start CellProfiler 2.1. The CellProfiler interface consists of the pipeline panel to the left, which is divided into input modules and analysis modules. A space for module notes for annotations and a file list will appear to the right. To provide CellProfiler with image files to be analyzed, drag and drop the input image files into the file list space. The input module metadata enables extraction of metadata information from the image file names and folders. Click on metadata in a list of input modules, and the module settings for the metadata module will appear on the right. Check the box Extract Metadata, and a number of options will appear underneath. Select Extract from File / Folder Names as the extraction method in order to extract the well IDs from the file names using regular expressions. To learn more about regular expressions, click on the question mark next to this option in the module settings. Click Add Another Extraction Method, and then extract the plate and gene names from the folder names using regular expressions. Verify your metadata extraction using the Update button below the module settings to ensure that each input image from the Images module is associated with the plate, gene, and well ID metadata. Next, select the input module names and types. Set the input image type to color image and assign the images the name RawData. The Groups module is not needed for this assay, so it can be left at its default setting. In order to load the worm model, you will need to adjust the output settings. Click on the View Output Settings button in the bottom left of the CellProfiler interface, and then adjust the default output folder to point to the folder where you want to store your output. Once the input modules are set, the analysis pipeline is built up by inserting modules into the analysis panel. Modules are added by clicking the plus sign next to Adjust Modules in the bottom left corner of the interface to bring up a list of selectable modules. Most object detection methods in CellProfiler are designed for bright objects in a dark background. Since the input images are color images of a bright background, the first thing we need to do is to invert the image pixel intensities. Adding the module called ColorMath, located under the module category Image Processing. Add the module by selecting and double-clicking it. The module has now been added to your analysis pipeline. When the module is selected, its settings are shown on the panel to the right where they can be adjusted. For this module, select Invert as the operation, call the output image InvertedRaw, and select RawData as the input. Most image processing algorithms operate on grayscale data, so the next thing we will do is convert the inverted color image into a grayscale image in two different ways. First, we add the module color to gray, and then combine the red, green, and blue channels of the inverted raw image into a single image that we will call OrigGrey. The image will be used to identify the worms. To see the effect of a module, click on Start Test Mode. It is now possible to step through the analysis pipeline and monitor the output at each step. Add another color to gray module, and this time split the red, green, and blue channels and call them OrigRed, OrigGreen, and OrigBlue. These images will be used for identification of bubbles and fatty regions. As it turns out, bubbles have high contrast in the red image channel and appear brighter than the worms in the inverted image. The same is true for the edges of the wells visible in the corners of the image. We can detect both of these structures in the OrigRed image using the object identification module IdentifyPrimaryObjects. using a manual intensity threshold of 0.5 and allowing a size range from 10 pixels to 10,000 pixels. Make sure not to discard objects touching the border of the image, as we do not want to lose clusters of worms where only one or a few worms are partly outside the field of view. In this case, we will not attempt to separate touching objects, and we will call the output well in bubbles. We also want to remove shadows surrounding bubbles and well edges. To do this, we will add the module expand or shrink objects and select expand objects by specified number of pixels, and expand the well in bubbles object by 5 pixels. We will call the output expanded well in bubbles. Next, we use the mask image module to mask the rich gray image with expanded well in bubbles to get a new image, masked gray, without artifacts. Make sure to invert the mask in order to keep worms and remove artifacts. We will now use IdentifyPrimaryObjects to separate worms and worm clusters from the image background. With the mask gray image as input, we set the size range between 20 pixels and 30,000 pixels in order to remove small debris and ensure that large worm clusters are kept. We use automated thresholding with global robust background as the method. Since there is a risk for empty wells, we also set a minimum threshold level at 0.09. In this case, we will not attempt to separate touching objects. Uncheck the fill holes in identified objects setting. Finally, we will give the name worm objects to the worm objects. We can view the worm identification results by stepping through this module in test mode. Add the convert objects to image module to convert the worm objects to a binary image, calling the output image worm binary. Add the module untangle worms from the worm toolbox. Set it to untangle using the worm binary's input and choose both as the overlapping style. This sets the module to work with overlapping mass when measuring size and shape, but non-overlapping mass when measuring intensity. Click the box for retaining both kinds of outlines and set the training set file name to the default wormmodel.xml file. Again, we can view the untangling result by stepping through this module in test mode. As a sanity check of the result, use overlay outlines to overlay the worm outlines on the original raw data image. Select the two outlines and call the output image OrigOverlay. Now that the worms have been identified through untangling, we want to begin to extract shape and intensity measurements. We start by adding measure object size shape to the pipeline and measure from the non-overlapping worm objects. Be sure to deselect the calculate Zernike feature settings since these measurements are not relevant in this context and add computational time. Since the true width of the worms will be biased by the width of the worm model, we want to extract the actual average width from the worm objects. We achieve this by using the morph module in order to calculate the distance transform of the worm binary image. Select distance as the operation to perform and call the output image worm widths from binary. Add the measure object intensity module to measure worm intensities. Select OrigRed, OrigBlue, and worm widths from binary as the images to measure. Select non-overlapping worms as the objects to measure. The measurements on worm widths from binary will provide information on the worm widths, while measurements on OrigRed and OrigBlue will provide information on the stain distribution and color. The Straighten Worms module from the Worm Toolbox extracts intensity measurements from subregions of the worms after digitally straightening the worms and dividing them into a fixed number of transverse segments in longitudinal stripes. These measurements can provide information on where fat is located inside the worm. In this module, we select non-overlapping worms to straighten, and specify the default worm model.xml file as a training set. We then select a single transverse segment and 5 longitudinal stripes. Note that if a head marker was available, all worms could be automatically aligned. We select OrigBlue as the image for measurements. Before identifying the fat subregions of the worms, we want to mask away all regions in the image that should not be considered as a worm. We do this by adding the module mask image. Set OrigBlue as the input image and worms binary as the masking image. The OrigBlue image is selected to define the fatty regions, since the oil-red O staining has its greatest contrast in the blue image channel. The output of this module is called MaskBlue. Now we use IdentifyPrimaryObjects to find the fatty regions. This time you let their diameter vary in size from 5 pixels to 10,000 pixels, and specify a fixed intensity threshold for what's regarded as fat, set for 0.4 for this dataset. This fixed threshold was selected by trying a range of thresholds and viewing the result, and should be adjusted for a new dataset. We do not attempt to separate clumped objects, but we do retain the outlines. We will call the output objects fat objects, and the outlines fat outlines. To be able to see the detected fat outlines, we will use the overlay outlines module to add them to the image in which we already outlined the worms, namely a ridge overlay. We do this by adding the module overlay outlines and selecting a ridge overlay as the image on which to display the outlines, selecting fat outlines for the outlines, and calling the output image a ridge overlay with fat. Run the pipeline in test mode and visually confirm the output. Now extract the shape and intensity measurements from the fat objects by adding the module measure object size shape, unchecking the Zernike measurement calculation again. We also add the module measure object intensity and measure intensity features from the OrigBlue and OrigRed images, with fat objects as the selected objects. In order to assign each detected fatty region to a worm, we add the module relate objects, with fat objects as the children and non-overlapping worms as the parents. We also check the calculate per parent means for all child measurements box to aggregate the fat statistics for each worm. Finally, we'll save all measurements, segmentation mass, worm outlines, as well as the images with overlaid outlines. Add the module save images, and save the ridge overlay with fat image using the raw data file name as the prefix and underscore res as the appended suffix. Next, add another save images module to save the worm outlines, as these will be useful later in the machine learning step in CellProfiler Analyst. Select the overlap worm outlines as the input, the raw data file name for the prefix as above, and underscore outlines as the suffix. Also, check the record file and path information to the saved image box. Add a third save images module to save the segmentation mass called overlapping worms, and save them as objects with the file name extension underscore worm underscore objects, and the format as TIFF, which is the only format for saving overlapping objects. These will be used as input for pipeline number 4. Export all measurements to an SQLite database using the export to database module. Choose SQLite as the database type and name the experiment My Experiment. Check the box to create a CellProfiler Analyst properties file and choose non-overlapping worms as the objects used for location. The plate type should be 96. Set the plate metadata to plate and the well metadata to well. Then specify that only selected objects will be used for export and select the non-overlapping worm objects. Your pipeline is now complete, so exit test mode by pressing the Exit Test Mode button. Since we've finished previewing the results, the display windows can be optionally closed to save time and memory during the analysis run. Select Hide All Windows on Run from the Window menu item to close all the display windows and have them remain closed during the analysis run. Then press the Analyze Images button to run the pipeline on all images. The output will be an SQLite database with measurements, a properties file for data exploration in CellProfiler Analyst, a set of images showing outlines of worms in fatty regions on top of the raw data, a set of images with outlines only, and a set of segmentation masks describing the overlapping worms.